This morning we woke up to the swift-boating hypocrites talking about Tim Walz's military service. A man who spent 24 years serving his state and his country in the National Guard. I posted a video this morning, and predictably, I knew exactly what the canned jackass responses would be from the usual suspects. I knew it was coming. There's no hypocrisy in cognitive dissonance like MAGA hypocrisy. These are the same MAGA motherfuckers that talk out of both sides of their mouth. MAGA is a disease that has robbed a lot of people of their dads, stolen by the hatred coming out of Fox News and OAN and Newsmax or whatever garbage outlets they have. So when a wholesome America's dad like Tim Walz comes along, MAGA starts looking for any crack in the armor. The claim, Tim Walz retired because he knew he was going to deploy to Iraq. Fucking bullshit. Especially considering some of the people regurgitating this horseshit ought to fucking know better. Yeah, motherfucker, I see you out there, lacking integrity and shit. Fucking scumbags. Tim Walz submitted his retirement request to the National Guard months prior to notification of his unit's deployment. This is a matter of public record and jives 100% with how retirement actually works in the military. His unit was fully staffed and his request was approved. He retired in May of 2005. The claim, Tim Walz is using a rank he didn't attain and that's stolen valor. Bullshit. And the Minnesota National Guard confirmed it. Walz never claimed he retired as a sergeant major. He retired as a master sergeant. That doesn't change the verified fact that he was the battalion sergeant major. And some of y'all motherfuckers out there are acting like you've never heard of somebody being frocked into a billet. So, again, it's a lot of veterans out there drinking MAGA Kool-Aid and completely losing their bearing and their integrity. I said it, bitch. But what do you expect from people in a fucking cult who worship a draft-dodging traitor who not only steals money from veteran charities, but also mocked a POW, berated Gold Star families going through their grief of losing their warrior, and then this same draft-dodging pussy called out our fallen warriors, called them suckers and losers? This is the same guy who was so incompetent of a leader that he failed in his own insurrection after losing his own re-election, who chose as his running partner a fobbit who never stepped outside the wire and wrote news articles from an air-conditioned office? It really fucks me right off when some fobbit pogue is talking shit about combat arms when they're not fit to hold the sergeant major's jock. Y'all don't want to talk about that, but you got a weird boner for Walz because he's a Democrat. I see who you really are, and you're fake as fuck. Y'all aren't patriots. You're what I call cosplatriots. I bet y'all are the same fucking perverts who had a boner for transvestigating an Algerian woman boxer, but didn't say shit about the straight white Dutch male who's an admitted and convicted pedophile. I didn't hear you running your fucking mouth then. I wonder why that is. Could it be that every accusation is actually just a confession? No wonder the world is laughing at you, you motherfucker. Now look, I get that I'm calling out vets for hypocrisy and I just called J.D. Bowman, I mean V.D. Chance, I mean J.D. Vance, I mean Vladimir Futon, whatever his fucking name is this week. I get that I just called him out for being a fobbit pogue. As a veteran, we like to say that it doesn't matter what you did, you still served. But to me, you forfeit that right when you willingly engage in lying and using vets as a background extras in your cheap political theater to besmirch your opponent. Don't fucking use veterans as pawns, you bootlicking simp motherfuckers. The Marine Corps is known for its honor and its integrity and not putting up with dishonor. So I am 100 fucking percent not taking any prisoners with people who play fuck games. You could have led with anything attacking his policy, even though that just reinforces the fact that you're sadly out of touch with what the majority of Americans want. Oh, but no. Instead, you had to pull some swift-boating bullshit that was soundly debunked in 2007 out of your ass. Y'all MAGA motherfuckers are on some bullshit if you think you're going to get away with that. No, sir. Now, I grew up in a Southern church-loving town where the Baptists wouldn't look at each other in the liquor store or the bar. I know what a hypocrite looks like. My other admins call these the Republican Party's ideological inconsistencies. A party that claims to be pro-life but supports the death penalty, guns, and war. Not okay with a woman choosing to yeet an embryo or a fetus when she has been raped or when her life is in danger, but totally okay with allowing a gun that can spew bullets faster than anybody can run away to be purchased legally by somebody who's criminally insane with no restrictions, essentially ensuring that we have national tragedy after national tragedy to the end of time. Good job. Fetuses and unborn children are easy to save. They don't require you to do anything but say, I'm saving the children! Yet, after they're born, you don't support any policy that would help them or their parents. It's fucking bullshit hypocrisy. We see you. Now, the Republicans claim to be the party of patriotism and loving the veterans, but that's easy to say and not easy to do, especially when your candidate is a draft-dodging traitor who doesn't know the fucking meaning of the word loyalty and patriotism. Who endangered our national secrets at a country club where anyone with enough money can, well, access the 1990s looking bathroom where those documents were stored? You don't even have to be fucking James Bond. You just have to have access to money, because that bitch is hard up for it. And now you pricks are going after a man who spent his life as a high school teacher during the week and in the National Guard on the weekends and 2 weeks during the summer where he served for 24 years? No. Those are two thankless jobs that require an attitude of service to your community, something the fucking Republican candidates wouldn't know if it punched them in the dick. Every one of you motherfuckers parroting this debunked bullshit should be ashamed of yourselves, but we all know that y'all motherfuckers need Jesus because you damn sure don't have any shame. The way that you're fucking carrying on, being a mouthpiece for fascists who wear you on their hand like the meat puppet that you are. People are acting like he abandoned his guys, but when he left after 24 years of service, he left a fully staffed unit of men that have nothing but good things to say about him, except for two mouth breathers. And yet Donald Trump left office, and of all the people in his cabinet, almost none of them think that he's fit for office. Y'all are acting like some fucking hypocrites, but that isn't a surprise since y'all have been nothing but hypocrites for the last 40 fucking years. No wonder your party is full of dinosaurs and is the fucking laughingstock of the free world. Hashtag not sorry, not sorry. Admin Tim 316 says, get fucked and die mad about it. Two claps and a rick. Woo! I had to change my fucking shirt because some bitch in my comments was like, your shirt is sexist. Y'all on some straight up bullshit. Y'all motherfuckers need Jesus. Y'all motherfuckers need Jesus. So I'm on my way to the gym, and I get these fucking notifications that are all like, this guy abandoned his unit. Oh, you mean the guy, the stolen valor guy?